In this video, we explore the most ingenious and innovative farming techniques used in different parts of the world. Vertical farming, aeroponic systems, snail farming, hydroponic feed, and more. Tevel's flying robots are drone-like machines that soar through the sky. But they're not ordinary drones. These are artificial intelligence-powered, fully autonomous fruit hunters connected to a station with a cable. They detect ripe fruits one by one thanks to the advanced cameras and sensors on them. They only choose ripe and healthy ones. And best of all, they don't drop the fruits they pick on the ground. They drop them directly into the transport system. Peat soil, a rich natural fuel source formed by plant residues accumulated over thousands of years. This system, which specializes in sod-type peat production, cuts the layer close to the surface with special machines. These cut blocks are spread out on the area to be dried in the sun. As they dry, they become stronger and are prepared to be converted into energy. This machine collects the blocks not one by one, but in strips, with its wide-mouthed scoop. It removes tons of peat from the area per minute. Here, snail farming combines traditional methods with modern technology. The farm raises snails of the Helix aspersa maxima and Helix aspersa Müller species. These species stand out for the delicious taste and nutritional value of their meat. The snails are cleaned every day, and their health is regularly checked. This meticulous care ensures high-quality products. They sell the snail meat to the gastronomy sector and the snail eggs to the luxury food market. This is no ordinary mushroom. It is reishi, known for thousands of years as the mushroom of immortality. Reishi mushroom is a powerful immune system boosting superfood. Cultivated in facilities like Joyaku, this mushroom is not from nature. It is produced in controlled and sterile environments, in special wood mixtures. The goal, maximum potency, zero pollution. Reishi mushrooms are harvested when they reach a certain size. The harvested mushrooms are dried, tested, and usually offered as a powder or extract. Plenty takes traditional farming to a whole new level. Instead of dealing with soil, the company grows plants in a closed environment in multi-story shelving systems. This system uses specially designed LED lamps instead of sunlight. In each layer, factors such as light, temperature, and humidity required for plant growth are controlled completely automatically. Seeds are placed on special surfaces and grow with nutrients carried by water. Thanks to this method, water consumption is significantly reduced and uninterrupted production can be carried out throughout the year without being affected by external factors. Each plant is monitored with sensors. The system automatically provides whatever it needs whenever it needs it. Forget about the classic methods of growing animal feed, because Hydrogreen has completely changed this. Without using any soil and without even needing sunlight. In just 6 days, they produce fresh, green, nutritious feed. Cereal seeds such as barley or wheat are laid on the shelves with an automatic seeding system. The seeds are moistened with a fine water mist and receive the water they need for growth. The roots are fed and cooled by an automatic drip irrigation system. LED lights located at each shelf level are turned on and off at certain intervals for optimal growth. In 6 days, fresh feed is harvested and ready to be fed directly to the animals or mixed into feed rations. The Dutch company Nature's Gold produces 6 million kilos of chicory every year. But this is not ordinary agriculture. Everything starts with chicory roots grown in the field. After these roots are harvested, they are taken to special storage at -2 degrees. This cold environment puts the plant into hibernation. In other words, nature's winter season is simulated. The roots coming out of the cold storage are taken to high-tech greenhouses. Humidity, temperature, and airflow are calculated inside. There is no soil. Instead, the chicory root grows in nutrient-rich water. Water is recycled in this system. There is no waste. Chemical drugs are almost zero. The chicory leaves slowly emerge throughout development. And finally, a snow-white, slightly bitter, crispy, and nutritious plant emerges. When harvest time comes, each one is carefully collected, packaged, and sent abroad. This method in India could radically change traditional potato production. The system is called aeroponic potato production. In this system, potatoes grow in the air, not in the soil. Potato plants are placed on top of specially designed tanks. Their roots hang down, but do not touch the soil. Instead, a mist is sprayed on the roots at regular intervals. This mist contains water, minerals, vitamins. In short, everything the plant needs reaches the roots directly with this mist. In this way, the plant receives exactly the amount of nutrition it needs. With this method, soil-borne diseases are reduced to zero. In traditional methods, an average of 5 to 6 mini-tubers are taken from a plant. However, in this system, 35 to 60 healthy mini-potatoes can be obtained from a single plant. We do not know if there is a change in the taste of the potatoes produced. Write your opinions about potatoes in the comments. Everything starts with the meticulous selection of the most suitable rootstocks and scions for the grape variety to be produced. Rootstocks serve as the substructure that will form the root system that adapts to the soil. Scions represent the upper part of the vine, that is, the part that will bear fruit. The selected rootstocks and scions are cut to specific lengths and thicknesses with special machines and made ready for grafting. These materials must be both free from diseases and genetically high yield and quality. Then, these two parts are usually combined using Omega or V-type grafting methods. Since this process requires precision and speed, semi-automatic systems are mostly used. The goal is to ensure that two different plant tissues fuse without damaging each other. Each seedling that has been grafted is covered with a thin layer of paraffin to prevent it from drying out and to protect it from external factors. This process also prevents infectious organisms, such as fungi and bacteria, from entering the grafting point. The waxed seedlings are taken to special callusing rooms where the temperature and humidity are carefully controlled. The aim here is to ensure that the living cells multiply at the junction of the rootstock and the scion and form the callus tissue. This tissue makes it possible for the two parts to grow as a single plant in the future. The process takes several weeks and is constantly monitored with a constant balance of temperature, oxygen, and humidity. Grafted saplings with callus tissue are planted directly in specially prepared open areas. Mulch cover is used in these areas, which preserves the moisture of the soil and prevents weed growth. Saplings are placed in carefully opened rows. Natural sunlight, wind, and contact with the soil increase the resistance of young saplings. It ensures the strong and healthy development of the root system. Irrigation is done in a controlled manner, and the growth of the plant is constantly monitored during this period. The saplings that have completed their growth and are rooted healthily are harvested. At the same time, DNA verification of each batch is performed, and its suitability for the desired grape variety is confirmed. Each sapling is then marked with special labels indicating its variety, production, year, and batch. Saplings that have successfully passed all these processes are certified by official institutions and offered for sale.